A robust strategy is insensitive to variations in price behavior, meaning it will continue to perform well when market conditions change. To simulate such changes, traders often include out-of-sample tests during development, like backtesting the strategy on a different market as shown here, or a different time frame. But what if you want to run an out-of-sample test on the same market and time frame? Here's where Monte Carlo simulations can come in handy. Monte Carlo simulation uses repeated random sampling to produce different backtest outcomes. It is most commonly used to randomize your backtest trade sequence, essentially producing a new equity curve with a different risk and return profile. This is a good approach to estimate your worst-case drawdowns. Check out the video at the top right to learn more about this process. Apart from randomizing your trade sequence, StrategyQuant's Monte Carlo simulator can also randomize your historical prices and strategy parameters. Both of these methods effectively shake your strategy to evaluate how much curve fitting has occurred over your development, much like how you shake a ladder before climbing it. If your strategy's performance suffers drastically due to changing prices or parameters, it has likely fallen victim to overfitting. To illustrate this, I'll use a pound-yen trend following strategy generated using StrategyQuant's genetic algorithm. This strategy trades on the hourly time frame, but enters the market on a breakout of the previous week's opening price. Trade management is minimal, with only a bar-based time stop and an ATR-based stop loss. Let's head over to the retester module and set up the simulation. Select Monte Carlo retest methods under cross-checks and choose the randomized history data test. 1,000 simulations should be sufficient. Unlike randomizing your trade sequence, a fresh backtest needs to be performed to create a new equity curve, so keep your computation times in mind. I prefer to use the full sample. By default, the simulations will only be performed on the in-sample portion of your data, which is configured under the Data tab. If you included an out-of-sample portion shown below, this portion will not be used for backtesting. Selecting full sample means all the available data will be used. When selecting backtest precision, you'll need to consider the specifics of your strategy. If you're not concerned about intrabar price action and your strategy has a large expectancy, I suggest choosing selected timeframe only. This is equivalent to the open prices only model in MT4. The alternative is 1-minute data tick simulation, which is equivalent to the default every tick model in MT4. This every tick model is much slower because it simulates tick movement by interpolating between the 1-minute OHLC prices. Probability up is the percent likelihood that each bar in the price history will have one of its prices, open, high, low, or close, increased. Max up change is the maximum allowable change, as a percent of the 14-period ATR. I'll use 30% for both fields. So for example, if the ATR is 10 pips, there is a 30% likelihood that the price will increase by up to 3 pips. I recommend using similar values for downside price changes since it is difficult to predict market bias. For keep connected, I'll toggle it to on. This preserves any price gaps in the original data series. Before proceeding, now's a good time to introduce the concept of confidence levels. Monte Carlo simulation is probability-based, meaning your results will differ slightly each time you run the simulation. It's like flipping a fair coin 1,000 times, you're not going to get 500 heads every time. In theory, your backtest metric will converge towards a certain true value after running an infinite number of simulations. This is obviously an impractical approach. A good compromise would be to run a sample of simulations, 1,000 in this case, and use confidence levels to quantify the uncertainty arising from this smaller sample. A confidence level refers to the probability that the sampled results contain a parameter's true value. This table shows a typical result from a Monte Carlo simulation. With a 95% confidence level, there is only a 5% probability that the net profit will be lower than $834, and the drawdown will be higher than $215. Higher confidence levels result in greater deterioration of your Monte Carlo metrics, but these metrics are more likely to encompass your future performance. With an understanding of confidence levels, it's time to input the test filters. These will be useful if you're using the Monte Carlo simulations to shortlist strategies. Head over to the Filtering tab. For this case, I'll use the backtest return over maximum drawdown ratio as the parameter of interest. I want the return over drawdown at the 95% confidence level to be at least 50% of the original ratio. I'll set up the left-hand side. Select the relevant robustness test. Monte Carlo retest methods is what we're using. The 95% confidence level is commonly used. You can use this to adjust the difficulty of your test. Even if you use a 100% confidence level, it doesn't mean that future performance cannot be worse. Monte Carlo simulations are estimations, after all. Now for the right side. The backtest setting is similar to above, but this time we will be using the original backtest as a benchmark, so select main data. Like the use full sample option described previously, I will use all the available data, so select full. For direction, select both, since the strategy trades symmetrically on the long and short sides. Resultant depends on what units your metric uses. It is irrelevant here because return over drawdown doesn't have units, although money is selected by default. For apply percentage ratio, since we want the Monte Carlo return over drawdown to be at least 50% of the original, set the percentage to 50%. If you trade a small account and are concerned about capitalization, maximum drawdown is an alternative. That's it. Let's run the simulation. We get the characteristic Strawbroom Monte Carlo charts. There are 1,000 additional equity curves, each created by backtesting on different historical data. As a consequence, the curves contain different numbers of trades and final equity values. The original equity curve is mostly in the top half of the broom. This means majority of the simulations resulted in worse outcomes, which is not great. Here are the confidence levels. As we progress through the confidence levels, the return over drawdown tends to deteriorate significantly because we expect a simultaneous decrease in profit and increase in drawdown. The 4.24 return over drawdown at the 95% confidence level is 51% of the original value, so the test barely passes. Now let's try the simulation with randomized strategy parameters instead. This test randomizes your strategy parameters. Robust strategies remain profitable over a large range of parameters. This strategy only contains two parameters, the number of bars used for the time stop and the multiple for the ATR-based stop loss. The fewer parameters you use, the more robust your strategies tend to be. Like my engineering design lecturer would say, complex strategies fail in complex ways. Setting up the simulator is largely similar to what we did previously. Select randomized strategy parameters from the list of available simulations. Probability is the likelihood that each parameter will be changed. I'll input 30%. Max change is the maximum percent change that each parameter will be subjected to. I'll input 30%. For example, there is a 30% chance that a 100 bar time stop can have its value change to anything in the 70 to 130 range. Symmetric parameters will be on. This means the same parameters will be used for both the long and short sides. Once again, we run the simulations and get the Strawbrooms. They look quite similar, but there is one key difference: there is a much larger variation in the number of trades per simulation. This is likely due to changes in the length of the time stop and size of the stop loss. The 95% confidence level return over drawdown also passes our 50% filter. So far, the strategy seems robust. It has performed reasonably well in the face of changing prices and parameters when tested in isolation. Being a perverse tester, I can't help but think, what if we randomized both prices and parameters simultaneously? I did exactly that, and the chart looks more scattered, with even larger variation in the number of trades. This time, the 95% confidence level return over drawdown is down to 42% of the original. If you want a more stringent robustness test, this is the way to go. So if you're a fan of out-of-sample testing, using Monte Carlo simulations to randomize your prices and strategy parameters is an option. Supplementing these simulations with other robustness tests, such as walk-forward optimization and multiple timeframe backtesting, is a great way to defeat overfitting. Check out the videos on the right to learn more about these. If you want to check out StrategyQuant's Monte Carlo capabilities, don't forget to use coupon TAC to get a 20% discount.